your mind. 'Cause I don't think we're finished until I cross the line. 'Cause I can't let you go. I want you to know that I will make you mine. 'Cause I can't let you go. I want you to know that I will make you mine.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sahara. In my last video, I did mention that I will be leaving the Philippines and the day has finally come and I'm here in Canada. I was thinking, why not document my journey so that you will be somehow familiar with what's going on right now at the airport. Before we proceed to the video, don't forget to hit that like button if you found this video helpful in any way and subscribe down below. It'll really mean a lot to me. Let's talk about my travel experience from Manila to Vancouver. If you want to know more about how to bring your pet with you, at least a little bit of that, then I will also be discussing that in the video. If you don't, you can just skip ahead. I'll try to provide timestamps down below. I booked a ticket to Vancouver from Manila for November 3rd, 2020, but then some flight schedules changed and it was moved to November 5th. Always make sure to check your emails and spam folder just in case. Also, you can always call them. They don't really respond to emails quickly, but just call them. Make sure that your flight is reserved. It's good. You're confirmed. If you're bringing a pet, also make sure to inform them. You have to make sure you have all your pet's requirements done. For the Philippines, there are certain documents that you need. For Canada, there are also certain documents that you need. So just make sure that you have them both. For my luggage, I did buy an extra luggage online. I bought three luggage and is it luggages? Luggages or luggage? So my flight was supposed to be at 2:30 p.m. Philippine time. And I had to be there around 4 hours before the flight for international flights. My terminal was Naiya Terminal 1. There are three terminals, I believe. And just make sure that in your ticket, you read which terminal you're in. I was done filming, but then I forgot to mention about the COVID testing thing. So it really depends because the government at one point required everybody who is going to the airport to have an antigen test, a negative antigen test. Some countries like Dubai, they require to have a negative PCR test and others don't. So like for example, in Canada does not require you to take a test, but they do require you to go into a 14-day quarantine. You have to also check with the news because sometimes they change it, especially in the Philippines, they do change it a lot. And sometimes you need a certificate of health or you need a antigen test or you need a PCR test. But during the November season, I did not need any of those. You have to contact your airline, do your research. So do your research on the requirements of your destination country. Or just do your research and you'll be fine. So I booked the Grab at 8:25. Be sure to book a Grab for four people because if you bring a lot of stuff, it won't fit in the one person or the two person Grab. So take note of that. I booked the Grab at 8:45 and then I arrived in the airport at around 9:10 in the morning. As soon as I got to the airport, the waiting area outside was filled with people. No more seats. There are no seats anywhere. So I think it discourages people to stay and you couldn't really see the lines at the entrance very well. So I thought that the ones with the hazmats in my video, I thought they were the lines and I was standing right behind them. Turns out they were not. And I don't actually know why they're wearing hazmat suits. You have to check with your airline and check with the country that you're going to if they require you to wear hazmat suits, what PPEs they require. For Philippine Airlines, I am required to wear my face shield and my mask to make sure that the mask that you bring is correct, because like for some hospitals they don't accept masks that have that little like let's side here. But just to make sure, just bring like one of these masks or like these KN95s. This is the one I wore because it was like more comfortable. Just make sure it's going to be comfortable on you because you won't be able to remove it anytime, and except when you're eating, and it's gonna be a long flight. After you find the lines at the actual lines at the entrance, you're gonna have to ready your passport and your ticket. Make sure your passport's already open in the page where your name is and your picture is, so that you'll not rummage and then you just waste everybody's time. After going in, you're gonna go through your first X-ray. If you bring a pet, they won't go through the X-ray, they'll go through the side because they can't go through the X-ray. And you're gonna look for your check-in counter. I was looking for a PAL check-in counter to Vancouver, And it was not a very long line, although the airport does look very intimidating because of all the people. But really, that's just people going to a lot of them going to Dubai, and the others are wearing hazmats. I don't know where they're going. When you find your line to check in, some assistants will be giving you declaration forms, like health declaration forms. There are two of them. The Philippine government is encouraging you to download the Trace app, and I'll be putting it here and linking it down below. You can do that as well. I didn't use it as much as I thought I would, maybe because it was just new at that time, but just download the Trace app. Another note for the declaration forms, just make sure you know where you're going, what address it is or what city, and the contact number that they can reach you. When it was my turn to check in, I just checked in all my luggage, and then I also mentioned that I was bringing my pet. So she weighed the pet, and she told me to proceed to the agricultural quarantine office downstairs from the second floor of that building to have his export permit signed. I had asked somebody to help me, to assist me, because if you have to go out of the airport for any reason, even just to go downstairs, you're gonna have to go back up and out and then go to that line again and have your stuff x-rayed all over again. So if somebody assists you, the process will be much faster. You don't have to really line up all over again. And if you have a boarding pass, you also don't have to line up all over again. So when you get to the agricultural quarantine office, you're gonna have to submit his export permit and your boarding pass. They'll just sign the export permit. Once they sign the export permit, you're free to go back to check in and leave your pet with them. Make sure that his container is following the guidelines. I'm gonna be putting the link down below with all the guidelines you need for a proper pet carrier. After the check-in, you can proceed to immigration. So at this point, if you wanna go out to say goodbye to whoever's coming with you, you're gonna have to do this at this point, because once you go through immigration, you can't go out to the airport anymore. Quick note, if you come with somebody and they're waiting for you outside the airport after check-in, they won't be able to take a Grab going home. You cannot pin it in the airport, because I think the government is not allowing that. They're only allowing certain transport services for that. So whoever is gonna come with you has to walk somewhere away from the airport and pin themselves there just to go home. But once you go through immigration, camera's not allowed there, so I wasn't able to film there, but you're gonna have to fill up a small declaration card and ready your passport and boarding pass and your confirmation of permanent residency if it's applicable. They'll just take your picture. You're gonna have to remove your mask, your glasses, and your shield, and they're gonna take your picture. And when that's all done, you can proceed to your gate. So I finished checking in around 10 a.m. and immigration was really fast, maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes. After immigration, you're gonna have to go through another x-ray. I think I had to remove my shoes at this x-ray before going to my gate. So this whole process took me about an hour to complete. The longest one was the check-in, because I had to wait a long while and I had to process my pet's documentation. I'm gonna burp. Excuse me. But after immigration, everything's good. All you have to do is to wait. So when you proceed to your gate, it really depends which gate you are, but you will be passing by some food stalls. Some are closed, but some are open. I know Starbucks was open at that time. And there's another x-ray that's even more tedious. Tedious? Is that the term? Tedious? Better eat if you're hungry, buy pasalubong, go to the bathroom before you go through that x-ray, because once you go through the x-ray, my mistake was I went inside. I knew I had to go to the bathroom. I went inside anyway, and then I thought I could wait it out, but then I had to go to the bathroom, so I had to go back out, go to the bathroom, and do the whole process all over again. So I suggest eat bathroom pasalubong before you go inside through that particular x-ray into your gate. On my boarding pass, the boarding time was at 1:45 p.m. My flight was supposed to be at 2:30 p.m. but I think the boarding was around 2 o'clock. I was expecting some kind of social distancing inside the plane. So I was in that big airplane where there's 3, 4, and 2 aisles, but there was no social distancing, unfortunately, when it comes to the seating arrangement. I think you could have asked if you could change seats, but I didn't. So maybe you could try. I was near the wing area and I was a window seat. That's a tip. I prefer the window seat because if people come and go to the bathroom throughout the flight, they won't, you know, hit your armrest or your arm. So that's less contamination just in case. And the hard part is, you know, you're in the window seat. So if you want to go to the bathroom, you have to go through two people who have to get off their seat. But anyway, you still paid for the flight. So don't worry about that. You get to your seat, you will be given a small pillow, a blanket, and a pair of headphones that's only good for the entertainment system in the airplane. Make sure that at this point you sanitize everything. I brought this multi-purpose wipes with me to sanitize everything you could possibly lean against, the window, the tray in front of you, the entertainment system, and even the one beside you. You can sanitize. The chair is sanitized, but I still put sprayed alcohol anyway, just in case. Throughout the flight, you're going to be required to wear your mask and your shield, and you're only allowed to remove the mask and shield while you eat, but the mask has to just be like over here. Luckily, there was an entertainment system in place. I did not know that. I thought, you know, there was nothing. So I had downloaded everything on my broken phone and I watched it on here. And then I realized, oh, decent movies, nice movies, lots of music and everything. So no problem. Takeoff was at 2:55 p.m. So we were around 30 minutes off of our scheduled time, but it was not a big deal. The flight takes around 11 hours and 30 minutes, give or take. The first meal was given around 2 hours after takeoff, and you're given two meal choices. Another tip is don't sit too far at the back because you will run out of choices. That happened to the row behind me, so I was lucky I was able to choose. I liked the meals, they were yummy. I really liked them. So you're given one meal, I think that was dinner, around 3:40 p.m. Philippine time, and then around 7 o'clock p.m. Philippine time, we were given an asado bun, which is like a bun with meat, and then around 12:30 a.m. in the Philippine time, we were given breakfast. So around an hour before descent, we were given these declaration forms. We had to declare what we were bringing into the country. Are we bringing like live animals, seeds, you know, tobacco, alcohol? In my case, I was bringing my cat, so I ticked in live animals. You also have to declare if you're bringing more than 10,000 Canadian dollars. This is important because immigration will ask you this. The landing part was smooth. PAL always has the best landing. I mean, I just feel like I feel so safe with Philippine Airlines all the time. I've never had a Philippine Airlines flight that had bad landing, maybe once, but it's always so smooth. We touched down at 2:01 a.m. Philippine time. That was around 11 o'clock Canadian time a.m. Oh, by the way, another cool thing. We left the Philippines on November 5th at 2:55 p.m. We arrived in Vancouver, Canada on November 5th at 11 a.m. So, you know, cool time, cool. I went back in time. So I lived November 5th twice, which is kind of cool. With deplaning, unfortunately, there wasn't a process either. They just kept on telling us to observe social distancing, but there wasn't like this process when we boarded the plane, it was like per section. This part, it was like the usual thing. I would have expected a little bit more organization with deplaning, but you know, people were still cautious about social distancing, and you should too. You don't need your shield when you arrive in Vancouver. Just keep your mask on, please. So when you get into the airport, there'll be a line, your very first line. You're gonna have to ready your passport, and then you're gonna go travel to the arrivals area, which is very, very far. It's kind of intimidating, the arrivals area, because you have to go straight, then you have to go up you make a U-turn, go up the escalator, and then turn left, and then walk, and then turn another left, go down the escalator, go down another set of escalators, and then you're there. It's kind of intimidating, but there are signs up in the ceiling, so don't worry about it. By the way, whoever lands in Canada has to have a 14-day, it's a mandatory 14-day isolation period because of the COVID thing. So you're going to have to make sure that your quarantine plan is in place. They will be asking you that. Once you get to the arrivals area, you're going to have there are these machines that you're going to have to ready your passport. The machines will ask you your name, your passport number, and it will have to scan your passport as well. So as long as the machine is green on top, there's a light, it means that's an available machine. The red one means it's being used. So you're gonna have to line up. If you don't know how to use it, don't worry, there are assistants there that will help you. And something will be printed out, like a receipt or something. Hold on to that. You're gonna be showing this to the CBSA, the Canadian Border Services Agency, who will be asking you about your quarantine plan. So quarantine plan is just basic. Basically, where you're gonna be staying, how does this the place look like, where you'll be staying in that place, how many people will be with you, and how you'll have access to medicine and food, and if your bathroom and kitchen are outside or inside. And then they will tell you, like, if, for example, in my case, the bathroom is shared, the kitchen is shared, and they told me you can use it as long as you sanitize everything afterwards. So yeah. Okay, I finished filming again. I forgot to mention, you're gonna have to download this app called ArriveCan. I will be linking it down below. It is where you just declare everything online. It's an online platform for that. But not only is it used for like declaration of things, it is also used by the Health Agency of Canada to monitor your 14 days of quarantine. You know, if you have symptoms, if you don't, you need the app, just download it. It won't hurt to download, and it will also help you with the quarantine details that you need to know. So after the CBSA, you're gonna proceed to immigration. So the immigration depends on, like, if you're a permanent resident and if you're a worker or a student, they're very nice there, don't worry. After immigration, I had to do one more step. At this point, after immigration, you can get your luggage. And I had a lot of stuff, plus I had my cat. So after immigration, I went to get my luggage, and then I had to get my cat on the far end. And it was funny because I was carrying this trolley full of my stuff, and I had to carry my cat on my one hand, and just like, it was hard. There are people there who can assist you, but I was too shy to ask if they were, you know, free, if the system was free or not, because, you know, in the Philippines, everything is being paid for. So I was kind of like, I was kind of scared. But don't be like me, go ask. If you need assistance, just ask. Once you get your stuff, you have to go to the agricultural office, which is right next to immigration, and declare him there. All they need is the rabies vaccination, make sure it's up to date. You have to pay a fee. It was around 35 Canadian. And the thing is, they're gonna fill up the form for a fee that you have to pay, and you're gonna have to go all the way to the back near the exit to the cashier where you have to pay. So I had to bring all of the stuff all the way there, and it was really, really hard. But I was just, you know, I was stressed as well because my cat was stressed. I wanted to pay in cash because, I mean, I immigrated from the Philippines. All my bank details in the Philippines, they're gone. And unfortunately, they do not accept cash. I don't know if this is normal for non-COVID season, but during COVID season, they will not accept cash. I was like, oh my gosh, they don't even know how to help me because I have cash. Oh my God. Luckily, my sister was there. She had a credit card. Take note, guys. If you need to pay anything, make sure you have a credit card with you because that will really help a lot. You need a credit card. They will not accept cash. Here's another thing that went wrong. Remember that machine where you scan your passport, where you like log in once you arrive? Turns out it scanned my passport, but it printed my name completely wrong. I didn't notice this. So check your receipt, make sure your name is spelled properly on the receipt, not on the screen, on the receipt, because on the screen it was correct, but once it was printed, it was wrong. So if there's any wrong details printed, make sure that you ask somebody to assist you and have that fixed before you proceed. Turned out it was a mechanical machine error, not my error. All of my documents were correct. It was just that little receipt that was wrong. So he had let it slide and he had let me leave. and I was out of the airport. After that, I took a lift, and now I'm settled in one of the bedrooms for 14 days. It is now November 11th, so I only have 7 more days to go, and I'm just so excited to be out. I just need to get out. So there you have it. I will be updating my channel with more stuff related to Canada. A lot of people are asking me how I got my permanent resident visa. I will be making a video on that very soon. What did I miss? I don't think I missed anything. I think you need to see my cat though.
Hi baby. How's the baby? Oh, hello. Are you happy you're here, baby? Oh, you're happy. Oh.
There you have it, everybody. I hope that this video helped you in any way. Please stay safe. Stay safe. Like this video if you found it helpful. And comment down below if you have any questions that I might be able to answer or might address in the next video. And subscribe. And I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.
Baby, we got something special.